In the calendar, we have the option to create a series of planning tasks assigned to different users based on the members of a dimension. In this example, we'll generate a series of tasks to get users to update the Q3 forecast for their respective regions. Keep in mind that we can't generate the tasks until we've first created and selected a process to contain them all. We'll enter a title and assign the process to our own user account. Next, we need to set the start and due dates. In the Designer panel, we can see the process details. The common work files, description, time, and additional information attachments we add to the process will be inherited by the tasks we generate later. But the context won't be inherited because a unique context is generated for each task. In this case, we won't add any details to the process. Now we'll create the tasks. First, we need to choose the appropriate model. Next, we need to specify the driving dimension, which is the dimension with the members that are involved in the tasks. In this case, we'll generate tasks based on the members of the region dimension. Next, we have the option to automatically select assignees and reviewers based on attributes of the dimension. In this case, we'll define assignees based on the person responsible attribute. Keep in mind that if we don't choose an attribute to define the assignees, we'll need to choose assignees manually for each task later on. In this case, we won't assign reviewers. Here, we can see all the members of the driving dimension we've selected and need to choose which ones we want to create tasks for. Keep in mind that tasks are created only for the members at the bottom of the hierarchy, and processes are created for the other members. In this case, we want to create the tasks only, so we'll clear the checkboxes for the other members. Next, we can adjust how to name the tasks. By default, they're set to use the parent process name, followed by the description of each member of the driving dimension. We can name the task based on the dimension member IDs instead, if we want. In this case, we'll enable the option to activate the tasks automatically at start time. On the preview screen, we can see a list of the tasks to be generated, along with the names of the assignees. The assignee names came from the person responsible attribute of the driving dimension, as we specified on the assignee and reviewer screen. Now we're ready to generate the tasks. We see a message that the tasks are being generated. Note that in this case, we can't see the task because the process that contains them is still inactive, so we'll activate it. The tasks have all been generated. When we select the task for the Asia-Pacific region, we can see that it's assigned to Priya. Priya's tasks have been added to her calendar. In the details, we can see any work files inherited from the parent process, along with the context for the specific task. When we finish the task, we can submit our work. Depending on the task, we may need to attach a work file or perform work on a common work file shared by the task owner. Back in Joanna's account, we've received a notification about the task for the Asia-Pacific region. Here, we can see that the Asia-Pacific task is accomplished. Once all the assignees have completed their tasks, the status of the parent process will switch to accomplished. Thanks for watching.